After I had learned some basic programming, I realized that I had enough knowledge to implement a snake clone in the console. I just had to make an infinite loop, clear the screen, throw the snake, and handle the user's input. The only problem was that scene would just block the game. I even tried moving it into another thread because I wasn't able to find what we are going to learn here today. We will also learn what this strange twin version of the main function is, so let's get into the tutorial. GetAsyncKeyState, while it has a complicated name, allows you to get instant information about the keyboard. Take a look at this code. It will print A every time I press the A button. Okay, now maybe you want it to behave like typing. If I open a notepad window and type, you will see that as I hold the key, it will register once and then repeatedly, but slower. To do this, you just have to check if the first bit of the return value is set. I'll quickly mention that later, when we'll be opening our run window, we will use something different for input, but now let's make a keylogger. A keylogger is a virus that runs in the background and registers every key pressed in order to hopefully steal some passwords. Don't steal passwords. Stealing passwords from other people is illegal unless other people give you the permission to do so. In that case, I don't know why they have passwords, but who am I to judge? So we will just iterate through all the 256 possible values, because if you look at the documentation, all the possible inputs are less than 256. Let us just use the uppercase ASCII code, while other keys have special macros starting with vkey underscore, meaning virtual key. Note that you can also get the mouse clicks with this function. This is the result, and you'd probably want to send the output to a file. Now, how you do make the console disappear? If you try to debug a Windows application, you will see that main is not actually the entry point. Main CRT startup is the entry point, and basically the C++ runtime will do some initialization stuff first, and then it will call the main function. So let's take a look at this call stack. NTDLL is basically the Windows kernel, and it calls into, well, another Windows kernel stuff. Then we finally get to the C++ entry point that will eventually call into our main function. It is possible to write this function yourself, and that means no to a lot of C++ features. You can check this video if you're interested in that, but right now, we want something else. We want to tell the C++ runtime library to use the winMain as the entry point. This is the entry point of a graphical application in Windows, according to Windows documentation. If you use CMake, this is the line that you want to add, and if you just use a Visual Studio solution, this is the setting that you want to change. Now, since we won't be able to see a console anymore, let's just use what we learned in the previous video and make a message box appear. Awesome. Now, you might be wondering, what all these parameters are? Well, the first one is a handle to the instance of your program. The second one is not used anymore. The third one is the command line argument. And the final one tells your application how to open. It is basically this setting from here. We will return here when we will be creating our own windows. In the next video, I'll mention how to also open a console with this setup, so subscribe to not miss that out. So, now your first piece of homework is to add the winMain function to the keylogger and lock the keystrokes to a file to complete it. Don't forget to add some more keys here, and also make a way to be able to exit the program. Use the Microsoft documentation to look at all the possible keys inputs. Now, for the second homework, you'll have to implement a snake clone or just implement some movement in the console using what you have learned today. You can use systemcls to clear the screen. Don't forget that you have to include CSTDIO, and also, to make the player move to the desired speed, you can just call sleep, because that would also block the input. So use this template that I gave you in the description. In the next video, we will learn some more things about the console. For example, how to remove this weird flickering thing and other interesting things, so make sure you subscribe and stay tuned to not miss that out. I hope you enjoyed my WinAPI tutorial so far. If you want to support me, you can do that directly by joining my channel, and you'll have access to the tutorial videos a little earlier as thanks. But don't worry, they will always remain free, and I'll still upload them fast. So if you can't afford that but still want to support me, don't forget to share my videos and check out my channel. Thanks!